Hello everyone, today's topic is web analytics. Let us see what it is, how we will be using it, and what works best for us. So in the beginning, we shall be seeing the history of it, some of the features of web analytics, the market evaluation, advantages and disadvantages, and finally what works best for us. Let us dig in. In the year 1990, the birth of World Wide Web. The internet was basically a dialogue of HTML code flowing back and forth between the web user and the web server. On December 25th, 1990, Sir Tim Berners-Lee successfully implemented the first dialogue, creating the internet as we experience it today. In the year 1993, the creation of web trends were introduced. Each time a HTML element is requested by a visitor, it was called as something called as hit, and it was recorded into a log file. A hit may include text, image, audio, or video file. Moving to 2004, the creation of Web Analytics Association was done. Web analytics became more established as an essential tool for web optimization. It provides increasingly complex solutions and reported massive amounts of data. Moving to 2005, Google buys Urchin Software. And finally, in 2012, we have something called as Universal Analytics. The universal analytics means that the user can be tracked across multiple devices and platforms through user IDs. And finally, today, the web app and design are heavily influenced by analytics. We cannot dream of designing a website or app without alpha or beta testing and tweaking. Let us see some of what exactly is web analytics. So, web analytics is the analysis of a website. It gives the performance statistics, loopholes, etc. Web analytics delivers information about a business site, visitors, and their behavior. It is done so that we can find information about them and measure what's bringing the traffic and what exactly is wrong, and improve the website's performance and conversion rates. There are various aspects of web analytics such as tag management, consulting, conversion optimization, training, usability analysis, and testing. Let us see one of the features, tag management. Tag management is a new foundational platform that enables marketers to easily connect and unify their digital marketing application. It also includes the search engines, email service providing, advertising, social technologies, etc. Let us see conversion optimization. Suppose that we are shopping on Amazon or eBay from USA or from United States. There are two different continents and of course having different currencies. The conversion rate optimization, also known as CRO, is a way to increase the amount of visitors that eventually get converted into customers, or they actually take design decision on the web page. CRO is the latest digital marketing tactic that makes use of web analytics as well as the user feedback to improve the performance of a website. Let us move forward and see the features of web analytics. There are multiple features, and these are just few of the top features which have been picked. Mobile access, data visualization, data exportation, traffic filtering, data analysis, actionable items, analysis of social media traffic, data storage, and dashboard. Let us see few of them. Let us see the mobile access. This is a flexibility feature, allow a user to have web access or analytic information anywhere and anytime via mobile phones. We have the various apps and browser on the mobile phones. So, data visualization. This feature provides the marketing reports in the form of graphs, charts, and other form of visuals. These visualizations help to provide the information quickly. Traffic filtering. There could be chances that you and your staff could be spending quite some time on the company's website. This feature helps in filtering off the traffic that the team when compiling reports by specifying the IP address. As you can see, the information and the filtering details here. We shall be seeing a demo on how to set these filters and how exactly it works. Coming to dashboards. As a company, it can customize the software dashboard which will suit the business needs. So as you can see here, the global market of web analytics was valued at about $3.9 billion in 2009, and it will be expected to reach close to about $12 billion by 2027. That is about $8.85 billion increase in just 8 years. Here, one specific thing which I noticed which was interesting was in 2019, the revenue in terms of North America was about this much, and finally it actually dropped in 2020. That is probably, I am assuming, it is because of the ongoing pandemic. Here again, in the in this article, we can see that in North America alone, the total sale revenue was about 5.2 trillion, and out of which USA itself is contributing to $4.7 trillion. Moving on to the scope of web analytics. So based on different categories like solution, services, deployment type, application, and region, we have different scopes mentioned here. So under the solution, it can be search engine tracking, marketing automation, behavior-based targeting. This particular feature also we will be seeing in the demo very soon now. So the deployment type could be, it could be on-premise or it could be on cloud as software as a service. And it could be the applications of web analytics could be in social media marketing, performance monitoring, displaying, advertising, optimization, etc. So based on the users and type of the searches they do, the different advertisements are narrowed down and shown to the user. And of course, based on the region. So here, these are some of the free and commercial tools available in the market right now. The free ones are marked in green. along with the downloadable link here, and the prices of each of those software tools are listed here. So Clicktail is one of the free web analytics software, where the free version is the bronze version is $99 per month, silver and gold is listed here, and it supports all the web operating system and it is software as a service. And Clicky, It analyzes the web analytics in real time, and it supports the Google Chrome or other browsers. Moving on to Google Analytics, how to sign it up. There is no downloadable EXE or something. You just have to sign in and register your website under this. The standard version is free, and it mainly focuses on the social value graphs, network referrals, etc. Open Web Analytics and Infusion Lab. These are the free softwares which are available. And this is a comparison chart with respect to the tool versus the top features. That is, does it have mobile compatibility? Does it support the geolocation, on-page analysis, the funnel conversion, e-commerce analytics, keyword analytics, etc. So we shall be seeing the remaining part of it in the part 2. Thank you.